Hi everyone, welcome back to Wisdom with Online Classes. My dears, in our previous class we were discussing about climatic conditions of different parts of Earth. Is it? In that, we come across two important regions. The first one is polar region and second one is tropical rainforest. Is it? Now, in today's class, we shall discuss about only the polar region and which of the animals are living in a polar region and how they have adapted themselves to live in such a cold climatic regions. Okay, you just see here what I have written on a board just for your reference as a point. The first thing is polar region. And in polar regions, these regions are covered with snow. Okay, these regions are covered with snow. We already know that Antarctica is it. This is a country which is mostly covered by snow. Here in polar regions, some of the countries will come across the polar region. Already, or which are those countries I have said you in a before class? Is it? Go through your textbook and check which countries will come under the climatic conditions, and all those countries are mostly covered with the snow. Okay, here the polar region, it is covered with the snow. Now in winters, the temperature can be as low as 37 degrees Celsius. My dears, this is the winter season we are facing, is it? And we feel very cold only for 28 degrees Celsius. But you just imagine the life if the temperature falls up to minus 37 degrees Celsius. Minus 37 means below zero. Is it? Below the freezing point. How can they live there in such cold climatic conditions? And one more important and amazing thing is, in polar regions, for 6 months, the sun will never set. And for the 6 months, the sun will never rise. Okay? Means, for 6 months, the sun will be rising. And after 6 months, the sun will never rise. Okay? Like that, for 6 months, they will get the sunlight, and another 6 months, they do not get the sunlight there in the polar regions. In such a cold climatic conditions, they are living. Means some animals are living there. How is it possible to them to live in such a cold climatic conditions? We shall discuss that in our today's class. You just see here, adaptation of some animals in polar region. And which are those animals? Means what I have written on the board here. Polar bear, penguin, musk, oxen, reindeer, foxes, seals, whales and some of the birds. All these animals live in a polar region. And already you know that what are penguins, and we are very fond of penguins just because they look very cute. They are black and white in color. Most of their body part is streamlined, and they are having a claws which are having webs in their claws, and those help them to swim. Is it? And they are very good swimmers. You know, in such a cold climate conditions, how can they live there? Just because a fat which is present inside the body will make their body warm. Okay, a thick layer of fat will be present inside their body, and that will make them warm for themselves. Their body shape is streamlined. Already I have said you what is streamlined. It is a boat like structure of fish like body. Okay, fish shape of a body of fish is streamlined. Like that, here also means bulged at the middle part, and it is narrow at the edge part. That is called streamlined. And here the penguins are having streamline, and their wings are helpful for swimming, not for flying. Okay, helpful for swimming, and they can walk easily in a island, okay, which is covered by snow. And also, my dears, they will get themselves warm by standing themselves thickly by one each other. Okay, you might have observed this, you might have experienced this. When you are in a hall with so many people and the hall has been closed, what happens? You feel very hot because of thickness of a people, is it? And we feel warm if we sit side by side in a winter. If you are going out with the friends, if you feel very cold, what will you do? You just sit side by side, and it will get somewhat warm for you, is it? like that. Here the penguins will stand line by line very thickly, and they will get warm. They will warm up their body due to the cold climatic conditions. And also, one of the most important and very fond animal, very fruitful animal for us is, that is polar bear. Is it? Just because I hope all of you are fond of teddy bears. Is it? And that teddy bears nothing but resembles the polar bear, which is having the fur on its body. Okay, which is having the fur on its body. How does it adapt to such a cold climatic conditions? What are the adaptations in the body of a polar bear? We shall see that in today's class. What I have written in first point, it has a layer of fur under a skin. Means it has layer of fat under a skin. Means under its skin, under the body, inside its body, a layer of fat will be there. Okay, that a thick layer of fat will be available. Thick layer of fat is formed under the body of a polar bear. How does it have? It acts as an insulator. Okay, it acts as an insulator to overcome the coldness of a polar region. It will make the body warm for itself. It will protect the body from a cold climatic regions. Okay. Next thing is, it has two thick layers of fur. Not only one, it has two thick layers of fur. You might have observed a teddy bear, it has fur on outside of a body. Is it like the thick fur? Means it's having long hairs and very thickly grown hairs on it, on the body of a animal. That is called fur. Just like a rabbit, you might have observed the rabbit. If you touch the surface of a rabbit, you will come to know that it is very smooth in its surface. Is it like that? Here also, outer side of the body is covered by two layers of a fur. Okay, two thick layers of fur, and it will help them to overcome from a cold climatic regions. It will keep the body warm. Okay, it keeps the body very warm. You might have observed that in winter season, or you might have experienced that in winter season, what will we do to overcome this cold? We are wearing some sweaters, is it? And nowadays the sweaters are available in such a manner that they have fur on outside. Is it? That look very beautiful, and also it makes our body very warm. Like that, here also the natural sweater given by the god itself, it has been on a surface of a, on a body surface of a polar bear. Okay, that is a natural sweater for them. Next one, the white fur is not easily visible in snow white background. My dears, here the polar bears are commonly in white color. Is it? Just because, how does it help? It helps to protect themselves away from, or to stay away from the predators or their enemies who will attack them. Okay, their enemies who will attack them for their food. So it makes, it is not easily visible in snow white background. Means that the snow white is also very white. If the animal is also white, if it is walking in a snow, it will not be visible for the predators easily. So it can protect itself to live in a polar region. Okay, it helps the white color of fur helps it to protect itself from its enemy. Next one is, it has a very strong sense of smell. You just observe, the god has given a very natural look to it. It has a very sense of smell. Means if it is, the food is under the snow, then it can smell. Then it can smell the sense of a food, and it can take out that food from the snow. It can take the food out of the snow, or it can smell the distant food. Okay, it can smell the distant food, and it can go and prey there. Okay, like that. Here it has a very strong sense of smell. Next one, it has long, curved, and sharp claws. It has long, curved, and sharp claws. Claws means legs. Okay, it has to walk in a snow, so it has long curves. Curves means bend. Okay, it has long curves and sharp claws. Sharp claws means it can hold clearly. It can insert its claws into the snow. So it has sharp claws which can hold tightly into the ground. Okay, it helps it to walk easily in the snow. We cannot walk easily in the snow, so we are wearing some kinds of shoes which are available in the shops or markets to walk in a walk in snows. Is it snow areas? Snow here they do not wear any kind of shoes, or there will be no availability of shoes for that. So the God itself has gifted them with the sharp claws. Okay, with sharp claws and a long curved legs. Okay, with a long curved foot, so they can walk easily in a snow regions. Okay, the snow covered areas or polar regions. So this is all about our polar region and how actually the animals adapted themselves to live in a polar region so that they can live for a long life in that polar region. And you might have adapted something for yourself to live in such in these climatic areas. If we go from warm area to cold area, we cannot live there, or we cannot be very comfortable there as like we are here. Okay, just because we have already adapted ourselves to live in this area. Like that, the polar bears also adapted themselves to live in a polar region. Not only polar bears, all these animals which comes under the polar regions have adapted themselves to live in a polar region. But the adaptations may be somewhat changed from one animal to another animal, but they have made their adaptation for themselves. That is, very natural adaptation has been going on in those animals. Okay, and most important thing is, in polar regions most of the animals have fur on their body to overcome from the cold climatic regions. Okay, thank you my dears. In today's class we have learned about what is polar region and which are the animals living in polar region and how they have adapted for polar regions. Okay, I hope you all understood about the climatic conditions of polar region. In our next class we shall discuss about the second climatic condition, that is tropical rainforest. Okay.